I am joined by Dr. Marcia Slattery, a professor of psychiatry and pediatrics at the University of Wisconsin and director of the University of Wisconsin Anxiety Disorders Program. She specializes in the treatment of anxiety and stress in adolescents and children, and has some great advice for all of us on how to help kids navigate the changes brought on by COVID-19. Hello, Dr. Slattery. Thank you for joining us today.
Hello, thank you for having me. It's my pleasure and privilege to be here with you today. Thank you.
We're very happy to have you here. So tell us, what do you see the causes for additional anxiety and stress among kids this year? And what can we as adults do to help?
Well, I'd like to start out by reviewing what helps kids feel not so anxious. That's really what I like to focus on to bring us back. And that's predictability, what I call the three P's: predictability, purpose, and people. And the big stressor, obviously, was COVID. When COVID hit, predictability, purpose, and people basically went out the window. It was very acute, was very sudden, and everything became very disoriented. So the acute stage, the stress related to that was very much trying to adapt and assimilate to what just happened. We weren't going to school, we weren't going to work, everything was changed, we were told not to be with people. So everything we were used to was suddenly gone. The abruptness caused a lot of stress and disorientation. But here we are now many months into it. And so the kind of stress that we're experiencing now is very different. And it's much more of a chronic stress. What I describe as kind of a feeling the burn, if you will. Kids are tired of virtual school. They want to be with their friends. They want to be in their activities. Parents want to be with their friends in usual activities, et cetera. And it's causing a lot of stress at home because we can't do the usual things that we want. It's also stressful at home. Parents, many of them still working at home, many of them financial difficulties and stressors, as we know, and just not being able to be with people, our extended family and our friends, et cetera. When you know, we're wired to be with people during times of anxiety and stress. And now during this time when this hits, we can't. So COVID has really been the big stressor in really disrupting all of these different major domains of life for us. And so when I think about what do we do for kids, or how can we think about it, how can parents think about it, I go back to my three P's: predictability, purpose, and people. So predictability, we can build in a lot of predictability in our homes. And in fact, it's very important that we do. So I advise parents, make a routine, a very basic schedule that you have every day when you have school and study time, keeping sleep steady and predictable, and keeping meal time and interacting with friends and activity time, trying to have a variety besides just screens, and making a very simple routine every day, writing it out and posting it somewhere and putting it like on the front of the refrigerator or something so people can remind ourselves, this is what we have for the day. Our brain kind of says, this is our roadmap for the day. So it's very important to keep the variety there and to keep the predictability. What's also important though, is when we can't go out and do the usual things that we want, it's important for parents to remember to build in fun things that are also predictable for their kids. So instead of going to soccer, for example, on Tuesday and Thursday evenings, for example, it may be that we have family night, like board game night or movie night, or things that are scheduled just like they would for activities outside of home, and things that are enjoyable. Not, well, if we get time, we'll do these things. These are things that we really need to build in and put on the schedule. So very important for parents to remember to build those in for things for kids to look forward to. Now, the second P is purpose or focus. We all need a focus and need a purpose in our day. For example, when we go off to work, we know what our job is and what we need to do. For kids, that's school. So school is an important part in what they do in school. But it might also be for younger kids, things that they're coloring, projects that they're doing, et cetera. And a really important part of having a purpose and for kids of what they need in their activities is to give them feedback on it. In other words, not to put them on the other side of the room and say, I want you to go over here and work on something for 2 hours, but instead say, I want you to work on the following things. Here are the three things I want you to do while I'm checking in on you. And I'm going to see where you're at the end of this period of time. Kids need that feedback. We don't recognize what teachers give, how they validate kids. They did a good job. They're there to help them when it's things they don't understand, for example. And so it's very important that we give kids feedback about what they're doing. So it's not that they're doing it for no reason, but really that we care and we're looking and we're paying attention to it. So giving them a sense of purpose in what they're doing is important too. And finally, the third P, people. Kids really need to have the interactions with other individuals, particularly peers. We're at a time when we can't be with them, so we really need to maximize what are the virtual ways that we can do that with video chats and texting and phone calls, et cetera, in person when it obviously is safe. But trying to find fun activities too. For example, I just heard last week of a team, they did baking together while they were on FaceTime together, which was fun for them to do, or other activities like that, so they feel connected, and that's very important for kids. For parents, it's very important to also feel like they're a consistent presence in the life of their kids. And one thing that I often recommend to parents is to find a time during the day or in the evening when you connect with your kid every day. And a favorite time that I like to recommend to parents, particularly younger kids, but for all ages for that matter, is when your kid's getting ready for bed and they're getting into bed and about to go to sleep, pull up a chair and sit there for 5 minutes and just talk with them about whatever they want to talk about. There's no agenda. They could talk about what happened that day. They could talk about a trip that's coming up. But what you'll also find is that they will also likely talk about problems and concerns that they have. And that's a great way for you to understand what your kid is thinking about and what they're feeling. So connect with your kid, find that time to connect. The same thing, some kids are really struggling with virtual school. And I recommend that they reach out to the teacher and definitely see, you know, recognizing that teachers have a large volume too. But for some of these kids, just having a check-in for 5 minutes with a teacher makes a world of difference because they feel they've connected. They've made that connection with their teacher. And now they're much more invested and they feel like the teacher really cares and is noticing them. So finding ways to make that personal connection is really critical.
Gosh, these are all great ideas that parents can do at home. So thank you for that. Yeah. The three P's are great. Thank you for sharing your expertise with us today and giving us your time too. Stay well, Wisconsin.
Thank you very much.
You can view or print the feelings thermometer and view our guide for how to access children's mental health services at www.children.wi.gov.